I'm so glad to be with you today, and may the peace of the Lord be with you. Today, I'm going to talk about the truth about PDA. I don't know if you understand the meaning of PDA, public display of affection. This particular thing have affected in real life. It have affected a lot of relationship, the way you flirt around, you know, out of subconsciousness. You might not be aware now, because of content creation world we are, any slight thing you do now, people capture it and they bring it online, either you are aware or not aware. So paparazzi have taken another level in terms of content creation in social media. PDA have affected a lot of relationships. For example, you are somebody, or you might be a man of God, you are invited in a function, maybe you are human, people just feel that a man of God now is a spirit. Maybe you just cut your eyes or you make some move, people capitalize on all these things. It might be a smile, the way you hug a lady, or the way you smile or admire young girl. Maybe you might see a young beautiful girl you just admire just casually, but people will caption it in a different way, label it in a different way, and present it online. When your spouse or your girlfriend or someone you are in a relationship with saw that, they will begin to have different assumptions about you. Some might think that you are flirting around or you are not reliable. How can you do this? How can you do that? We need to comport ourselves at all time, because you don't know who is taking note of you, who is creating content with you, with your moves, with what you do, with everything. Be careful of PDA. This is not just all about the men. It could be you are as a married woman, you are out there, you went to a function, you are with your friends, especially when you are under the influence of alcohol. You might do some silly things, like the way you hug a young boy, or it might be your classmate, it might be someone that you knew for long. The way you smile, the way you get excited, some might even jump and hug, you know. So when those things are not presented online, and your spouse or someone, your fiance or someone you are in relationship with saw those scenes, they might read some things, some negative things. We are human. So that is why we need to be very, very careful. Very careful at all time where we go and how we do things. Because now people are creating content in every little thing. They just want to present something, because now it's like competition online. They want to present something as if they set a marathon, a race. Creating content is not by force. You must not be targeting negative things when creating content to present to your audience or to your viewers. There are so many content creators, all they are after is the mystic you make out there, the negative moves or the careless moves you make out there. That's what they're after. They are not after the good moments where you do good and correcting, but they're after your mistakes. So if you are out there, you are always looking at other people's mistakes to create content from. Don't forget, you are going to be a victim very soon. You will be a victim yourself of making mistake while people will create content from you. Whatever you do to others is coming back to you. It's called law of karma and law of nature. And this PDA, public display of affection, have affected young girls out there. the way you flirt online, you see so many young girls now, even 18 to they are from 18, even at times under 18, flirting around a man that is old to be your granddad. You'll be flirting, you are not scared, flirting around with them. If they just tell you without even asking you, you'll be requesting if you can offer them your boobs by entertaining them with your boobs or your nakedness online. So beware. Imagine all those your tapes are being taken record of and brought online. A lot of them have been exposed online, like some of them have been doing blue job online, showing their nakedness online. So many people have been a victim of blackmail through that. What you have done out of carelessness, people will use it against you. A lot of young girls that are online, that is the reason it's difficult for you to get married.
You've been broken and trashed into pieces, the doors are bad. Better days been afar. Tell me what is all of this about? Crying, wailing, exclaiming, now you're seeing the pains we enduring. Trying to search for my path. Feel I'm lost.
It's difficult for a responsible, decent man to put you at home. A girl that is stripping herself naked online, that is displaying her disposedness online, that is flirting around married men, both unmarried, whoever. You don't care. You just want to show yourself. You just want to sell yourself so cheap. So that is why it's difficult for you to get settled, to get married. Every responsible man is looking for a decent woman that can be nurtured, that can be cultured, that have sense of belonging, that have sense of responsibility, that is trained, not a flirt, not someone that is displaying herself online 24/7, offering her naked pictures online. So it's difficult for a man to put you at home. Be careful. You are a young boy out there. You don't know the effect PDA can cause to your life. Every silly mistake you are doing today might affect your future. There is no woman, responsible woman, that is ready to settle with a flirt. You are a young boy. You are busy flirting around with women that are old to be your grandma just because of desperation. That they will be giving you tips or giving you money. If you are a young boy growing and you have that brain, that mentality that is a woman that is going to give you money or set you up to be rich, you better have a rethink, because it is difficult for a woman to give you something for free. Even men, if you are a young girl out there, you are looking for sugar daddy to make you in life, to build house for you, to buy a car for you, to take care of your family, is a wrong notion. That is why you see majority of young girls today, they are into slavery. They are in slavery in their matrimonial home. Some of them have even become fourth wife. Some of them have become fifth wife, all in the name of money, because this man have spoiled you with money. And majority of these men, may you not fall into the hands of these ritualists. They will tamper with your destiny. Some of them, they are walking corpse. They are just walking corpse. Your destiny have been used. Your style have been used. Even your part of your organs have been used. Some of you are just in a marriage. You can't have children. Your womb have been used because of desperation for money. Beware of PDA, public display of affair. It affects men, it affects women, it affects relationship, it have destroyed about 70% of relationship. Because online is exposing people, every day. The careless mistake you make secretly, somebody will publish it online. And imagine your wife seeing you kissing another woman or another girl. Or your husband seeing you kissing another man. Something you did secretly, you don't know that there are paparazzi in there. They are taking picture of you. Do not forget, flirt, lust is a sin in the sight of God and in the sight of men. You cannot be flirting around and lusting around. After men are women, you are a woman, you are lusting, young girl, you are lusting after men because you are targeting their money. You think that is life for you. This is the life now. You enter internet, enter TikTok, enter Thread, enter Facebook, you see young girls frolicking everywhere, advertising, showcasing themselves, their nakedness, exposing themselves, showing bumble, showing breast. PDA is going to ruin you. I'm only here to advise you, beware of public display of affection. It will destroy your future. You better be careful. This is just an advice. It's not for everyone. A word is enough for the wise. The HEPA organization, all I do here is to encourage you to live decent, to encourage you to live a proper, normal way in order not to jeopardize your future. Your future is more important than today. And you will lay in your bed the way you lie it. So be careful. Once again, if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, do so. And there is a membership program in our YouTube channel. Once you subscribe to that membership program, you will have one-on-one counseling session with me. And it comes with full package. Anything at all, bring it aboard and I will counsel you. We'll have one-on-one meeting together. Remember, there is no single problem on earth that does not have solution. And it takes change, readiness to change. If you are ready to change, that is where transformation can take place. Remember, all things are possible if only you believe and you are ready to change. Thank you for listening to this video and do not forget to share this video to your friends, to your loved ones, and to your well-wishers, and even to your enemies. As you do so, God Almighty will bless and enlarge your cause. Thank you and please always be in this channel if you want to live a better life. All the videos are here to modify you. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for your like. Thank you for your subscription. And I'm here for you. You can make a suggestion in the comment section of the kind of video you want me to talk about or the kind of topic you want me to talk about. I'm here for you. God love you and I love you with all my heart. Thank you once again. Remember, see you in my next video. Thank you.